I've now been traveling to South America for 20 years. And whenever I return, I find new horrors hiding in its waters.
I recently came across a grim report from only a year ago. A young man was swimming across a South American river.
Suddenly, he started struggling and then disappeared below the surface. He was only underwater for a matter of moments before being pulled out. But it was already too late. He was dead.
But this was no drowning, as he had highly unusual injuries. According to the report, something under the water tore his face off while leaving the rest of his body untouched.
I head to the hospital to see if anyone knows how Oscar met his gruesome end. I find Dr. Navarro, the man who signed Oscar's death certificate. The first thing he does is pull out a photo of Oscar's injuries.
It is really very horrific.
But did these injuries kill Oscar, or are they covering up evidence of a stabbing or shooting? Dr. Navarro says there was no evidence of murder. Oscar was definitely attacked and killed by something in the water. So how did Oscar die?
And the cause was blood loss. Once anything attacking gets beyond the soft tissue, all it's got to do is puncture one of these arteries, and what with the pressure of the blood behind it, somebody can actually bleed to death in a very short time.
From the bite marks left on Oscar's head, Dr. Navarro is in no doubt as to what did this. Piranhas. For years, it's been an article of faith for me that despite the hype, piranhas don't normally kill people. Dr. Navarro's findings potentially throw this into question. This is the first time I've seen such graphic, gruesome medical evidence of somebody being killed by piranhas.
Is it possible to say which type maybe was involved here?
No, it's possible, porque no tenemos los medios para poder determinar.
He's saying that there's no real way after the event that you can tell which type was responsible. They're all very voracious, but pointing the finger can't be done.